Looking to transmute some unwanted cards into a booster box? Look no further than ChannelFireball.com's online buy list. We offer competitive prices on cards from Ancestral Recall to Zombie Master, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a 30% store credit bonus. Head to ChannelFireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's faster and easier than winning with a pack rat.
Hey guys, Sam Pardee here, going to be recording a cube draft for Channel Fireball. This pack is pretty weak. My favorite strategy by far in the like non-powered Moto Cube is a blue X tempo strategy. And there's only one blue card in the pack, and it's pretty good, but it doesn't really go in a tempo deck. The other cards that I think are powerful in this pack are Raphelos is quite good. He's super, super powerful. And Fire Drinker Satyr or Bone Splitter if we want to go into an aggressive strategy. I don't really think that I want to start the draft off with a multicolor card. I think the black cards are both just kind of bad. Yeah, this pack has like a lot of the mediocre red cards, I think. So that being said, I think I want to start things off with Raphelos. It's super, super good. In the deck that it's good in, it's just like the most powerful card imaginable, basically. Alright. So this pack has some nice ones. We got Rolling Earthquake is pretty strong. Raging Ravine, I really like having just a, I also like five color stuff as a deck quite a lot. Phantasmal Bear is not great, but in the deck that you play it in, it's pretty strong. And Baneslayer Angels, super powerful also. I think I'm just going to take Baneslayer Angel because I think it's the most powerful card here. Might be a mistake to pass the Ravine, but I like Baneslayer just fine. Alright, here is a Temple Garden that I think I'm going to take. None of these other cards are really getting me excited power level wise, and like none of these cards are nearly as powerful as Baneslayer, which is why I took it over Raging Ravine. And just having duels is always good, because like even if we don't end up as a green-white deck, we could end up with like a blue-green fetch and be a blue-white deck, and then our Temple Garden still does something awesome for us. So having them early gives you a lot of flexibility later. So Preordain, Lightning Bolt, Llanowar Elves strike me as the three best cards here. I really like cheap cards, and those are all three very, very good ones. I think I'll just take the Llanowar Elves. It fits with our Raphelos, and yeah, just basically because it's on color. I think that all three of these cards are close in power level, and so I'll just take the one that fits with the other cards we already have. Deranged Hermit is perfect in a green ramp kind of deck. Hopefully we wield this during Wildwood. But casting it on turn three off Raphelos is awesome. So we'll just grab that. Do a little cost sort. Alright, so here's a Savannah, a Wood Elves, and a Mishra's Factory to some extent. Although with Raphelos in your deck, really does pay to have as many forests as you can. And Savannah's value actually goes down a lot because we already have Temple Garden. So we could take Wood Elves. It's really between Wood Elves and Savannah for me. I like having extra green-white lands because then we can splash Baneslayer or, you know, just be a green-white deck that plays Baneslayer. I don't love Wood Elves enough that I'm going to pass on the dual land. All right, there's Wooded Bastion, which makes the Baneslayer super easy to cast. And then we can basically play any white card. Thornscape Battle Mage is pretty good, but not that good. Not enough better than just taking the land, I think. All right, here's Genesis Wave, which is very good with Raphelos, and so far our deck is 100% permanence. And there's also Obstinate Bailoff and Sacred Foundry, which would make any white fetch land be able to get us red mana also. I think I'm just going to take Genesis Wave because it's one of the better finishers, so to speak. So all the red cards came back except for Firebolt, which I think probably was the best red card in the pack. But I'll just take Uvenwald Tracker. He's not bad. It's pretty sweet with Baneslayer Angel. Maybe we get a Green Sun Zenith or something that greatly increases the value of sort of situational guys like him. All right, Troll Ascetic is an okay man. He attacks and blocks. Ratchet Bomb would also is definitely good against us and would probably be okay in this deck, but I think we'll just take the Ascetic. Shrieking Grotesque is really quite bad. Yeah, I wasn't positive I remember what that card did. Restock is okay. It's basically like a divination that always draws you two cards, so I think that's fine. I guess we'll t I think we should take Relic here. Hero's Downfall is surprisingly late for that card, but obviously we're not interested. But Relic is just a good hoser to have in general. And Linvala seems like a good card to at least not have played against us. I'm gonna go ahead and hide all these guys. I don't know if we'll actually want to start Linvala, but it's a strong card. All right, so this pack we have a fetch land, Swords to Plowshares, which I think is maybe what we're gonna take. Also Elspeth Terrell, who is pretty good but not actually great. And Farseek, which is definitely a powerful card. Also All is Dust, but that doesn't really work very well with the ramp guys we have. I think I'm just gonna take the one mana removal spell. This cube is not really like the Holiday Cube in that creatures are much more important, and having cheap answers to creatures is therefore also much more important. So there's Revelark, who is completely awesome. We have Deranged Hermit and a bunch of like one mana guys to get back right now. Also, there's Sylvan Caryatid, which is a solid ramp guy. Terastodon, which is a very good thing to be ramping too. And Windswept Heath, which is would definitely be good in our deck, but we already have three green-white duels. We're not totally hurting for another one. Heliod is probably not going to be that good. The Green God would actually be playable in this deck, but I don't think. Yeah, I wasn't sure if the ability cost white and three or white-white two. But it costing white-white two makes it pretty much out of contention. So I think here we kind of decide if we want to go with the mid-range or the full-on ramp plan. I'm more inclined to go with the Revelark because I prefer a mid-rangey deck to like a all-out ramp deck. So that's what I'm going to take. Here's a Verdant Catacombs in a pack that doesn't really have much else to offer us. Helps solidify our mana, maybe lets us splash a little bit if we want, like if this Sorin comes back around or something like that. Yeah, I'm just gonna take that. We're not really interested in Ismar or Hallowed Burial in our all creature deck. Vines of Aswood's actually a fantastic trick that we'd probably play if it wheels, but I'd rather have the land. So there's Fauna Shaman and Experiment One. Both are pretty good. I think we'll take the Fauna Shaman. We have Revelark, so we can, do some stuff with that. And the card's just really, really good. Scavenging Ooze? Yeah, I think we'll take a Scavenging Ooze. Emyria Angel would also be quite good, but when in doubt, take the cheaper card. And Scavenging Ooze can get monstrously large in this format. So there's an Acidic Slime, a Survival, and a Pride Mage. Curse Scroll's also definitely a good card. I think we have enough fives that I don't really want Acidic Slime. I think I'm just going to take the Pride Mage. Survival is a card that has really gone down in value for me lately in Cube, especially in a deck like this. If we were the full, trying to cast Terastodon style deck, it'd be pretty insane. Because, when you draw a land or elf on turn 8, you can discard it to go get Terastodon. So it'd still be good in this deck. Discarding our turn 8 land or elf to get Baneslayer Angel is still definitely good, but I want to just beat down with Pride Mages. Sounds more fun. So there's Nature's Lore. Is pretty okay. Finds us a white land to help us cast these guys earlier. Guess that's what we'll take. I like Manowar a lot also. Kind of sucks to pass that guy. But I don't know how. Well, I'll take the Manowar. No. I don't know how likely it is that we actually end up getting a couple blue lands that we can actually splash in. Yeah, I'll just take Nature's Lore, I think. Does make our Genesis Wave better and our Rephelos. Alright, there's a Moloku, which is a very good splash in a deck that can theoretically make a lot of mana. Palladium Mirror is okay, I guess. Yeah, I think I just want Moloku. It's nice that we also have Fauna Shaman, so if we draw Moloku and don't have blue mana, we can discard it. Really like a couple equipment in this deck also. So wheeling out of this pack. Still not interested in All Is Dust. We don't have a good ways to abuse it. I think I'll take Deadbridge Chant. Seems a little dicey, but it could be good. I don't know. We can kind of splash black off our Verdant Catacombs. Right now, I'm probably not interested, but if we pick up like a Bayou or something and we're playing against a deck where the game goes long, it might be better than restock. I'm not 100% sure. All right, I think Lodestone Golem might be good. Definitely going to be better than Heliod, which I don't think we're ever going to be able to make two tokens, and I don't think we're going to be able to turn it on very well. So, Lodestone Golem it is. All right, Vines is a solid comeback trick. It's very, very good. And I think we're more inclined to splash blue than splash black, so the Maelstrom Pulse in that last pack was not as interesting. I'll just take Bane of the Living because it's good against us. Same goes for Flash Freeze, although Searing Blaze is also excellent against us. I guess Apocrisite. We have a lot of fives. We don't need more. And Paladin Invec is a solid sideboard card that sometimes you main deck but aren't super happy about usually. So this deck feels a little underpowered right now. Could use a few more, like, one mana things to do.